So that's it for the module. What did we learn? We had a detailed look at the background property with all its sub-properties and also how you could combine them into the background shorthand. Important, watch out for position and size, which should be separated with a slash. Also, make sure you separate multiple backgrounds correctly with commas. And as for all shorthands, you should always remember that you override other properties when setting a shorthand, because the shorthand, even if you only use it to define a URL, will also initialize default values for all the other sub-properties. So if you add a shorthand as the last declaration in a rule, and you set background position, let's say, earlier, this will actually be overwritten by the default implied by the shorthand notation. We then had a look at gradients, at linear and radial gradients, and how you could control color stops, shape, position, and size of the gradients. We had a look at multiple backgrounds, how you can stack them, how the syntax works, and that you can only have one solid color, but multiple images, and that gradients count as images, and that you can use transparency to create cool effects. We also had a look at how we can style images, and I also did a brief comparison to background images and mentioned the accessibility problem we have with background image, which on the other hand has or comes with an advantage of giving us more flexibility. Not the accessibility problem gives us that advantage, but background image in general. Still, only use it for real backgrounds. That's my recommendation. You learned how you can control the image sizing and positioning and styling in this module too. And finally, we had a look at filters, another awesome way of adding visual effects to elements. Just keep the browser compatibility in mind. If you need to support Internet Explorer, you should provide fallbacks, use a polyfill, or don't use them at all. And that's actually it for backgrounds and images and all that fun stuff.